Fans, I'm Brad Nessler alongside my colleague Dick Vitale. We're here to call tonight's matchup between the South Carolina Gamecocks and the Baylor Bears. And here we have our two players who are the focus of our Star Watch for today's game. What's the starting five look like, you might ask? Well, whether it's a big game or a small game, your starting five has got to be ready to go, Dick.
We have two excellent players matched at the point guard position. It's going to be interesting to watch how they each try to get their team involved throughout the game.
And now for the tip. And with the tip, we're underway here in the first half. He attempts the jump shot. Off the mark. And we'll get a change of possession. The Gamecocks set up in their zone motion. On the outside, he tries to knock down the three. Missed the jumper. Goes up for two. Great shot.
That's Battledore defense. Nobody coming over. Nobody giving any help. I mean, that's how you see better defense on a playground.
Looking for a good shot. Unloads a three. Busts the jumper.
Up and inside.
Come on, Rob. I know you see it. I know you see it.
Tries for two. Scorches the net. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
The Bears, according to their coaching staff, have been doing a great job creating this up-tempo style. He's been praising their efforts and would like the team to continue to force the issue. They want easy baskets in transition. That's their strategy.
Thanks, EA, our third member of our team and our sideline reporter, keeping us up to date with what's taking place behind the scenes and around the bench. Good job, EA.
Trying to go inside.
Ball's going to stay here. Inbound on the baseline.
Unusual mistake there by the senior.
The Bears go into their zone motion now.
Nice low post play. Good entry to the box.
This team right now just lighting it up from everywhere.
Hey, they're finding each other in rhythm with their passing, Brad. That makes a huge difference in how shooters shoot. Turnover committed by the senior.
On the wing. Here's the big man with a drop step.
Oh, he does a phenomenal job getting post position, good angle, and then the drop step.
Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Well, here we have a look at one of the sophomores for this team.
Hey, underclassmen are an important part of any program. With a year under his belt, the coaching staff expects solid play from him.
How many fouls is that?
Got them both.
Oh, he drained it. That's him on nylon, NBN.
On the right side. He shoots from left of the circle. He nails the bucket. We've got a break in the action, folks. Stay tuned for more ESPN coverage of the NCAA. Play about ready to resume. The Gamecocks are going into their zone motion offense now. For the bucket. Goes in. Nice look on that backdoor pass, Dick.
Brad, those are the type of reads you look for in practice.
Now they work it around the perimeter. He unloads a three. Busts the J. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
They work it around the perimeter. He puts up the three ball. Can't connect. In terms of balanced teams, what might we expect from them game to game, Dick?
They feel they are more successful when they focus their attention on doing a bit of both, Brad. They have the personnel to be able to play up-tempo at one end and play in the half court at the other.
Gave it up. He puts up the J. Scorches the net with a J. Working it around the perimeter. They move it into the front court. Puts up the J. The missed shot. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. And off the mark. The point guard gets the pass. Trying to feed the low block. He shoots from the corner. Perfectly executed. Moving it around the perimeter. For two. He nails the shot.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
With the J. Nails a sweet jumper. In the lane. Nope. Here comes the ball screen. Trying to feed inside with a fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through. Off the mark. Time to pick up the defense here now. Down inside. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Looking for a good shot. Takes his jumper.
Excellent jump shot right there.
They work the perimeter. He attempts the trifecta. Missed the jumper. Number 15 handles the pass. Number 15 is animated and ready to go.
Hey, whether you win or lose, you shouldn't be afraid to show your emotions.
He pulls up with a jumper. Busts the J. On the dribble, gives it up.
Bad decision there by the senior.
Freeman handles the pass. Swatted away. Scores it. Silva handles the feed. Scorches the net with a J.
Turnover by the senior.
Now on the run.
Look at that spacing.
For the bucket. Off the glass and no good.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Goes up and come up short. On the right side. Two. Gets it to fall. How about the great job of getting to the basket right there, Dick?
That's a great job, Brad. Using his athleticism to get to the hoop and convert.
Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. The small forward with the ball. Takes the jumper. They get it to go. On the outside. He goes up with it. And score it. Tries the turn and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Takes the pass in the paint. Off the glass and no good. Freeman handles the pass. They'll work it around the arc. A little two-man action. We're at the 7 minute mark. He tries the jumper. Gets the J to fall. Well, let's take a look at the tempo each team is going to try to set for this game. Richard?
Well, whenever you have two teams looking to control the speed of the game, you need to keep your eye on how each team makes changes. Setting the tempo can be an advantage, but adapting can be just as important.
Missed it. He tries the fall away. Off the glass and no good. Pushes it up. From three-point land. Knocks it down. Low block. Goes up with it. The missed shot.
He's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
Yeah, it is pretty similar.
Wow. I didn't realize my partner was a high-riser.
Both teams looking to get things going here. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
They look to get it to the inside. Great blocked shot. Ball down low, puts it on the floor. Toronto fadeaway.
It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
There's the pick. Stop and pop. Perfectly executed. They're working around the perimeter. Tries for two. He makes the shot. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Oh, clinical drop step.
I tell you, clinic 101 on how to utilize the drop step from the low post.
a momentary look from three-point land. 4 minutes left on the game clock. Goes up with a shot. Nails the J. Freeman handles the pass. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
For the bucket. He drains it. Puts up the shot. Perfectly executed. Gave it up. Puts up the jumper. Can't connect. We're at the 3 minute mark. He shoots the jumper.
Excellent jump shot right there.
With the catch. Nice execution on the spin.
That's a great spin move to the basket.
Number zero picks up the foul. He got the layup to go and the foul is called.
Hey, he saw that he was going to get fouled, but he stuck to the path in spite of it. You know, with him in the lineup, they've got one of the toughest things to get in sports, experience. But remember, Brad, experience doesn't always come from being on the court. It comes in many different ways.
Makes the shot. Jumper. Bust the jumper. About 2 minutes remaining on the game clock. The shooting guard with the ball. Puts up the J. Bust the J. Circle. He misses the J. Inside for two. Scorches the net with a J. Looking to move it around the perimeter. He goes for three. Nails a sweet jumper. One minute left on the game clock. Puts up the runner. Off the glass and no good. On the outside. Goes up for two. Drains it. Jumper. And score it. Freeman receives the ball. Looking for a good shot. Top of the circle. Off the mark.
I tell you, they all want to take it to the rack. High wire rack, baby. Little tipsy dude, Dunkaroo.
With a big shot. And come up short. At the half, the Gamecocks are trailing by two. get going here today, these will be some of the keys that each team will be paying special attention to all day long.
We've seen a lot of action and some impressive play here today. A look at these numbers can give you an idea of who's been doing what.
Looks like they're going to go with a full court man-to-man press, Dick.
Up and inside.
Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. Number four handles the pass. They go into the low block.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
Now they work it around the perimeter. From the corner, knocked it down. They work it around the perimeter. Takes the jumper. Off the mark. Number 31 handles the feed. Goes up. Scores it. For the bucket. Nails the jumper. On the dribble, gives it up. He attempts the jump shot, knocks it down. Look at that student body. They are going mad.
Aren't they great, Brad? I love it.
Let's take another look at this deep three. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad foul right there, Brad.
Dumps it in for two. The shot won't fall. Nice rejection. Pushes it up. Goes up for two. They got it. Alley-oop. Tries for two.
Look at that! That's unbelievable, baby!
Gave it up. The Gamecocks have a player spotting up on the three. The missed shot. Freeman handles the pass. Takes the shot. And he missed. Working it around the perimeter. Number 20 is charged with the foul. The layup counts and the foul.
He went hard to the hoop knowing he was going to get fouled.
Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
He steps up to the line. It goes in. And the slam. Now that's what I call showtime.
You better believe it, baby.
Moving it around the perimeter. Gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Missed it. Number 31 takes the pass. On the dribble, gives it up. He tries the three ball. Nope. pushes it up, pushing in transition. I think that's why college basketball has the following it does, Dick. People from all over town and throughout the campus come and enjoy themselves at these games.
Wow, the energy is unbelievable in here.
He puts up the tray, busts the jumper. The shooting guard handles the feed.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
With a deep shot from outside. Missed the jumper. Looking for a good shot. He shoots from outside. Off the mark. They work the perimeter. Takes his jumper. Off the mark. Pushes it up. He hammers it home.
Spacing.
He puts up the J. He's not getting himself in position for the good shot.
Yeah, it's a little bit too much. One on one. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards out there.
Yeah, that helps. What do you think, Dick?
They need a timeout here, Brad.
On the outside. He shoots from the top of the key. There's a very tight lid on that rim for him right now, Dick.
That's right, Brad. Nothing seems to be dropping.
For that reason, right there, that's why I love college basketball.
You're right. The student sections, the bands, and the crowd are always urging their team to victory, like a sixth man.
The shooting guard receives the pass. He wants a three. They get it to go. On the low block, he pulls up with a jumper. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
He'll get the free ones. Misses the first shot. Be a pick and roll here, Dick.
You've got to love the pick and roll, especially when it's run to perfection, Brad.
His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
The small forward takes the feed. He shoots from the deep corner.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
That one. Now trying to feed the low block with a fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through. Tipped in.
What a great tip. What a great second effort.
it in for the bucket. They got it. How about that play? They went through the high post again.
Certain offenses require that the ball goes through the high post. This will usually open up things on the wings and a low block, Brad. They did a great job of using the high post on that play.
Arm and foul. And a chance to make it a three-point play.
Yeah, good second effort to stay with it right there. Did a great job attacking the defense.
And there's a look at the young freshman.
Hey, Brad, a first-year player starting his college career. Really exciting times in front of this young man.
Foul shot is not good. And we've got a change in possession here. It's a team effort across the board so far today, Dick.
It's been great to watch them move the ball like that, and they're doing all the things it takes to win. They're committed to playing good team defense, and when your team is doing those type of things, you're smiling as a coach.
The small forward receives the pass. As the fans continue to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Gets the rejection. The shooting guard with the ball. Can't connect. For two. Sinks it. With the J. Knocked it down. It around the arc.
Shooter spotting up on a three.
Trying to pack it inside. He goes up with it and score it. Goes with a great block. Pushes it up. Throws it up. Tries for two. Makes it. 7 minutes left on the game clock. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. There's a slam. The Bears should consider switching their current tempo and mindset to more of a half-court game. With the time and score on their side, that seems to make sense to me, Dick.
Hey, knowing when to settle down in the half-court is very important. When you have the lead and the clock is winding down, the offensive goal should be to have longer possessions.
Now with 10 to shoot. They work it around the perimeter. He fades away. He misses the fadeaway. On the right side. Momentary look from three-point land for the bucket. You betcha. 6 minutes left on the game clock. Number four handles the pass. Nails a sweet jumper. Top of the key. Fed the low block. There's a double team waiting there. He makes the jumper. Top of the circle, they're working around the perimeter.
For great effort defensively. He says, thou shalt not enter thy lane, baby. Get it out of here, I'm the landlord.
The layup is good. About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock. Tries for two with the layup. Low block. Goes up with it. He misses the J. puts up the J. He misses the jumper. Gave it up. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
I tell you, did a great job creating a good angle, too, when he goes up and under. He seals off the defensive player.
About 4 minutes remaining. Worked the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He hammers it home.
You can almost see that coming. They were a little bit lazy on the defensive end. Mr. Excitement with that jam.
With a bucket. Off the glass and no good. With a layup. Looking to move it around the perimeter. For two. Gets the J to fall. On the outside. Three minutes left in the game clock. Looking for a good shot. He tries the jumper. Knocks it down.
Up and inside.
He shoots the jumper. Missed the jumper. On the left side. He attempts the three. Nope. Goes, blocks it. Number four. His modest performance is bringing down his confidence level.
Yeah, it's unfortunate to see this, Brad. I feel for him.
Now they work it around the perimeter. About 2 minutes remaining on the game clock. Tries for two. Rims out. On the dribble, gives it up. Off the glass. On the left side. For two. Can't connect. Goes up for two. Was that beautiful or what? Lobs it. Tries for two. And we're going the other way. They might have him in some trouble here, Dick.
Great trap, Brad.
Ball's coming from the sideline. About a minute remaining in the game clock. Sideline inbounds. Ball coming in from the sideline. The Bears really struggle from the free throw line.
Free throw shooting is probably one of the things that the coaching staff would love to improve upon. They realize the importance of being able to knock down free throws.
Count it.
Michael screen. So effective, that screen.
the free throw line. It's the first. Hits his second. The small forward gets the pass. They will line him up. He buries it. Makes his second shot. Here they come with a double team to stop it. Great trap. They managed to keep the defender in check.
The man can't get past it, Brad.
They work it around the perimeter. Here comes the ball screen. For the bucket. Off the glass and no good. The point guard with the ball. Shot clock is dead. Here they go in transition. Working it around the perimeter. He intercepts it. Gave it up. Let's take a moment to look at our players of the game here today.
These two kids were awesome all day, Brad. They both played their hearts out. Their coaches have got to be happy.
Baylor showed vast superiority tonight in this blowout.
This is a shocking upset that the school will be celebrating for the next week.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners, Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.